Hi everyone, this is Ash, and welcome to my latest video to come on my channel of June 2014. Well, on your screen is a HO scale Japanese Shinkansen train, which is the E5 basic car set from Kato, and I've been after one of these for a very long time. As I no longer model in N-gauge, I've always been looking for a HO scale Shinkansen, as the model is obviously larger. And before we open the box and have a look at all the gorgeous eye candy that this model has to offer, I'm going to go through the details first. The reference number is 3-516. I believe this could be a Tohoku Shinkansen or something like that. And it also tells you here that the second carriage is the motor coach, as where you get another trailer and the two non-powered driving trailers which have directional headlights. I have read on forums that you would need to hardwire at least 4 decoders into this train, and I will explain as we go through this video. Anyways, enough of the chit chat, let's get this lid off the box and let's have a look at this gorgeous eye candy that's inside. Just like with the N-gauge counterparts and the American Kato models that I have, you get a sheet of decals. You can apply these to the model according to your taste. And here are the instructions. Now, if we open these up, despite that the language is in Japanese, there is some pictorials of how the train formations are formed. And the full set consists of 10 units, and I do have plans to make a full 10 car of this Shinkansen, as I am on the lookout for the two extra carriage packs that are available separately. Right, let's start with the unboxing, as there is no more paperwork to take care of, at least not for now anyway. I have checked underneath the individual trays and there is no more paperwork, although in the top section there is some detailing parts that you can add later. Right, let's start with the rear car first because I want to show you something. Underneath here there is a switch. Now if you slide that forward very gently, this will pop open the working Schaffenberg automatic coupler. And what we need to do next is gently seed this back into the body of the train. And also, if we just press these two black coloured tabs inwards, which is these inner ones here, I hope you can see this on the video. Just slide these two forwards and there you go. There's your coupler, ready to use with another Shinkansen, as two Shinkansen units can be coupled together. But please note, it's only this car that has the working coupler. The leading car, which is in the top, does not. Right, I'm just going to put this back together, so just bear me for 1 minute. And I will be back once I've put the coupling back together, and I'll commence on with the rest of the unboxing. You know what, on second thoughts, I'm going to show you how to put the coupling back together live on the video. And then, once I've tidied up the coupling, I will pause the video briefly whilst I put this trailer on the track. As it is quite a fiddly job, but all you do is you just press the two black tabs inwards and just ease them downwards. It's fairly easy to operate, then just slide this lever, the same tab as you did when opening the couplers, fully forward, then line the two halves of the coupling doors together. But you should push the lever all the way to the top until you hear it click into place. Now I'm just going to go off camera whilst I line these up. Be warned, it is quite a fiddly process, so just be patient, and once you have the half linked like so, just gradually push the levers back until it makes a nice flush sealant around the nose cone like this. Also, you shouldn't be able to feel any gaps if the coupling is snug or the shroud doors are snug. This is the correct way of closing the coupling doors anyways. Right, I'm just going to put that down there. Now it's time to move on to the third component in the train, which is just the standard trailer car. And you have got the close couplings. I have tested this train prior to making the video, and I can confirm that this train pack will work on Hornby fourth radius curves with no problems. I have pre-tested this before making the video just to make sure, and I can confirm that this train will work just fine. Just check out that beautiful interior detail. Also, on the underside, you have got brass pickups. This is for the optional lighting kit, as you can fit interior lights into this train. And I will make a start on this once I get the other two carriage packs. Well, that's the second carriage, do beg your pardon, complete. But I'll just show you that lovely aqua colour on the top of the carriage, complete with the lining and the markings. Absolute fantastic model from Kato, I must say. Right, now for the interesting bit, and I will explain in more detail. Right, this is obviously the heavier component, as this is the motor car. Now, unlike the N-gauge version, which had an underfloor motor connected to two drive lines, this has two motor bogies, as there's a motor mounted here, and if we just move across, there's also a motor mounted there, which is why I said you may need up to four decoders depending on how you wish to set up this train for DCC, as the end trailers will require one for control of the lights, and these motor bogies are actually independently controlled, as they are not connected in any way. So you've got like two motors on the one coach, which is a nice feature. Also, the interior isn't sacrificed either. And if we just turn the carriage to the top, we can raise the pantograph to around that height. I believe that's about the correct height for this train. And just like with the other two carriages, you've got the close couplers too. So, a very nice model from Kato. And also, there is some decals added on the sides. Very nice detailing throughout. And there's only one component left before we move on to the test drive, which is what I'm really looking forward to doing, trust me. Anyways, let's get the last component out. Please excuse the long arm cutting across the tray there. Just check out that nice graphic on the side. I believe it's actually a Hayabusa, this Shinkansen is known as, but I've had that wrong. Please feel free to correct me in the comment section. Also, looking at the front, the headlights and the tail lights are just above the driver's cab. And I may well go into the troubles of fitting a train driver into this Shinkansen. Just like with the other end driving trailer, I believe this could be the Grand Class, the one with the leather reclining seat, similar to that you get on airlines. And just look at that metallic green. This is just such a nice model. And to be honest, the wait for this to come in HO scale has been well worth it. And if anyone from Kato is watching this video by any chance, I would like you to consider making some more variants of the HO scale Shinkansens, especially the JR700 and also the JR300, as they are my favourite Shinkansens as well. Anyways, before we go away, there's just one more tiny bit left to cover. And that is the tiny little detailing parts, as these just fit into the model as advised by the instructions. I think they're optional parts. There's also a nice little tool in there in the form of a small screwdriver, I think. Yep, certainly is. This just aids with putting the detail parts onto the model, I believe. Right, that's all the unboxing and the paperwork and everything taken care of. I'm just going to disappear for a couple of minutes whilst I get this gorgeous model train onto the track, and I shall return with a ground view of the test loop, and then we can test drive this beauty of a model train. Stay tuned, I'll be back shortly, and trust me, the wait will be well worth it. Just before I commence on with the test run, I just wanted to show you how to couple this model train together. What you need to do is just line the two ends of the cars up together, then push firmly until you hear a click, like this. And that's what you really need to do with coupling this train together. And now, for the moment that you've all been probably eagerly waiting for of this part of the video, it's now time to commence on with the test drive. And just for the effect of this test drive and test run, I have raised the pantograph on the motor coach just for good effects. And now, without further ado, it's time to start up the power on the Gauge Master Model D. As you can see, taking the power to just under 20%, and you'll see that the LED headlights on the leading driving unit have just illuminated, and the model train is just barely crawling. Taking the power up to around 25%, the train pack now gains a little speed, and also the tail lights have also illuminated nicely on the rear trailing driving unit. Both driving units at each end of the train do have directional working lights, and as previously mentioned, there is a provision for an additional interior lighting kit, although it was originally designed for the N-gauge range. It has been engineered to work on this model as well. Just taking the power up to just 30%. I'm just testing how sensitive the motors are at the moment before we pick up more speed. And we're on exactly 30% now on the Gauge Master Model D train controller. And I have to say, I'm really impressed and delighted of how smooth this Kato model train does run, regardless of what speed the model is actually doing. So let's take the power up to 35%. Bearing in mind, this is less than half power for this train pack, as most of my other model trains you have to at least crank it up to 40% power to get anything out of them. But just like with the NTV Italo, this train is quite fast considering its first running in session, as it is advisable to give all brand new model trains a running session of at least 30 to 45 minutes, although some instructions do indicate an hour, but I feel that is a bit too long. Anyways, I'm going to be quiet for a couple of minutes and I'm going to let you enjoy the sights and the sounds of the Shinkansen. Also, in this position, I would like to show off the tail lights on the rear trailing driving unit. Well, I'm going to allow a couple of more passes in this position and it'll soon be time to wrap up this review with my final score and verdict on this excellent HO scale train pack from Kato. As you'll probably guess already, this train pack is definitely going to earn a good score from me. And likewise, more on that at the closure of this video. Well, after looking at this gorgeous eye candy from this model train pack, and also, this is my very first HO-scale Japanese Shinkansen that I've ever owned, and I'm well and truly impressed with the performance, the detail, the design, the running, absolutely top-notch all round. The only downside is that this model is not DCC ready by today's standards, considering this model is a 2013 release. But fitting a DCC decoder into this model isn't as hard as you might think. However, depending on whether you decide to have the full 10 car set that I'm going to be having, there is an additional motor car included in the extra trailer, so I've read, so you will definitely need at least 4 decoders. 2 for the end trailers to control the lights, and the other 2 for the 2 motor cars, as the motors can be wired in parallel so that they work from the 1 decoder. Although you'll probably need a heavy duty decoder, something like the lens silver or lens gold as a minimum, so it can handle the demand of the 2 motors. As this train pack alone has 2 motors, if you do go for the extension add-on pack, you will technically have 4 motors on this train as a complete length alone. Right, with that information over and done with, and just to make a few points, I'm going to finish off this review with a perfect 10 out of 10. As to be honest, it would be rude not to. Thank you for watching this video, albeit it's more longer than my other train videos, I think. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, have a great week, and see you all again soon. Take care, everyone, and bye for now.